her muscle.
That's true.
All right, we heard from 98 Degrees. They were singing. Thelma Houston is the Grammy winner. This is a pleasure. Thanks so
good
much.
Good morning.
Thank you for having
and
me.
And we're talking about my favorite thing about great singers. Before we play one of your signature hits, you've got to do, go ahead.
The warm-up, Sam.
The warm-up. I love that. All right, and you know this song. Listen.
Yes, Thelma.
Not for you.
That song stands the test of time, doesn't it?
Well, you know, it's something about that song that it. And you're right. It from the first time I performed it until now, when people say, "Oh, baby," it's
yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking there with an orchestra. My guess is you've performed that song basically everywhere all around the world.
Everywhere. All around the world. Mm. And I better do it, too.
Don't get up
people
that.
Expect you. Yeah. They expect you to do it.
And do you find they know it everywhere all around
they
the world?
They do.
What does that feel
they
like?
Do.
That must be the most
it
amazing thing.
It feels wonderful. Mm. It does. It feels wonderful.
Does the room grow as when you're about to
build,
hit that?
Yeah.
I'm told the show you've got going right now is around a lot of Motown music. Thelma Houston, My Motown Memories and More.
Right. It's a show. You know, do you know how there's certain things in your life, major things, but that happen to you, but there was some music, some song that was popular
absolutely.
At the time.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, well that's I was thinking about all these Motown songs that I love and was growing because those are my peers,
right.
You know, but they were so far ahead. They were in their careers.
Sure, of course.
And I was just dreaming about
right,
it.
Right, right, right.
But then that's how, you know, and at some point you come together.
I see what you mean. Can you tell me one or two of those songs? Name a couple for me.
Okay, well, for instance, I'm going to let you know a little secret. For instance, it starts in 1960.
Okay.
And it's in 1960 with Smokey Robinson's Shop Around.
Oh, great. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, well, Smokey was doing his career. He was writing his songs, Shop Around. They were back in Detroit. I was in Long Beach, California, okay? But I was a high school dropout at that time.
Okay.
So it's like, oh my God, I'll never be able to do this. I'll never. But then there came, by the time, Heat Wave.
Sure.
That's when my daughter was born.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I get it.
All right.
Yeah.
Then 1964, my son was born. Mm-hmm. Dancing in the Street, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, great song.
And then, so on.
But these songs serve really as signposts for your
life.
Everybody,
right.
People
and then I get on the label, and then I'm touring with the Four Tops. I'm touring with the Temptations, right? I'm being produced by Stevie Wonder. Wow. You know, so it just kind of comes together. And then I finally get a hit. You know, with Don't Leave Me This Way, which happened to be at Motown.
Right.
And I was the first female on the Motown label to win a Grammy Award. Most people don't
know. Oh, my gosh.
That.
No, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wow. One other thing we should tell you about, Thelma, of course, is your fantastic humanitarian efforts. Get this. Thelma Houston Day in West Hollywood is January 29th.
Yes.
So that is something. You've been very, very involved with a lot of charitable efforts. Talk to us about this gala that's coming up.
This is, it's called Carry. The foundation is Carry. And it was started by a very wonderful dermatologist by the name of Dr. Pearl Grimes. And Carry stands for the Coalition for At-Risk Youth, particularly dealing with children in the foster care system. Mm-hmm. And since her specialty is a dermatologist, she helps. Like, a lot of times teens are going through, you know, bad acne or vitiligo or things like that, which unfortunately is not always looked at as a necessity.
Right, right.
But it's so important when you're a teenager, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of it, and everything is done through volunteers.
Mm-hmm.
And they get no funding, government funding or anything. So, and it's gonna be this upcoming Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And it's gonna be honoring this time. I like to think of them as this era's Oscar, Ozzie Davis and Ruby Dee.
Okay.
But it's going to be Angela Bassett and her husband, Courtney
Vance. Oh, wow.
That's what I, yeah,
you know what?
Doesn't that set them?
Put up the information on the full screen here about the event. That's terrific. And they're terrific.
Yeah, they are.
It's going to be at the Beverly Hilton. Tickets for atriskyouth.org. Somebody named Thelma Houston will be there.
Yes, me and Pete Escovedo.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
This is like the greatest night ever.
Thank you, Thelma.
Thank you so much.
Such a pleasure.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. Thank you.